Whether it be as the leader of a band of mercenaries, or a thrifty merchant looking to get a good deal on trade goods, almost everyone can make good usage of speechcraft. Even heroic wielders of the Thum must sharpen their tongues as much as their blades. Hello, and welcome back to the fourth part of my in-depth guide to advanced mechanics for Wildlander, the roleplaying overhaul for Skyrim Special Edition. Today, we'll be examining the overhauled speechcraft and follower systems. To start off, we're going to take a look at how Requiem changes the speech skill tree. As opposed to vanilla Skyrim, which mainly focused on bartering and the rare and mostly useless speech checks, Requiem splits the speech tree into two main branches. The left branch shares many similarities with the vanilla speech tree. It focuses on bartering and your ability to trade. The right branch, however, focuses on the power of your Thum. For any character who wants to pursue ultimate mastery of the voice, the speech tree is essential. As such, in order to use any of the perks on the right branch, you'd need to select Dragonborn when creating your character, and complete certain main quests to unlock specific perks. The biggest addition to speech mechanics in Wildlander comes from immersive speechcraft. This mod adds in features present in previous Elder Scrolls games, such as taunting someone into a fight, as well as adding new possibilities for roleplay, like begging or asking someone to perform a task for you. Arguably the most useful features of the mod are the ability to barter with or receive training from any NPC. In order to use the new dialogue, you must not be wearing a helmet. Each of the dialogue options are governed by your speech skill, and as you improve it, you'll have a greater chance of success. For example, if you ask someone to help you in combat, whether or not they do so, and for how long, is determined by your speech skill. Additionally, your relationship with the NPC is considered, something which is expanded upon further in the next mod, Relationship Dialogue Overhaul. Relationship Dialogue Overhaul adds thousands of new dialogue lines to NPCs depending on your relationship with them. If you retrieved Amran's sword from an encampment of hostile bandits, every time you greet him, he will show his thanks.
Good to see you.
If you're caught stealing from Bellathor's shop, he'll scowl and threaten you every time you pass him in the streets.
I don't need to talk to you, get lost.
Much of this dialogue is repurposed vanilla voice lines or spliced together from existing dialogue, so it all fits right in with no jarring edits or unvoiced lines. The greatly expanded upon variety of voice lines means your interactions with the citizens of Skyrim are no longer dull and repetitive. Your close friends treat you with respect and admiration, and your worst foes insult you to your face. This makes the world feel much more alive and reduces the number of immersion-breaking moments of awkward dialogue common to vanilla Skyrim. For added immersion with the more generic NPCs like guards or townsfolk, everyone has now been given a real name, which is consistent throughout your playthrough. No longer is every single guardsman in Whiterun simply known as Whiterun Guard. You may get arrested by Wrathlord the Green at level 5 and come back 20 hours later to wreak vengeance upon the very same person.
You have committed crimes against Skyrim and her people. What say you in your defense?
The follower mod used by Wildlander is Follower Life Package, whose main utility is to extend the functionality of your followers. Instead of just being meat shields who would get in the way more often than help, followers in Wildlander are now useful companions who can provide a significant boon both in combat and outside of combat. New behaviors include being able to cook, craft, and wear different outfits depending on the situation, and more. They are far more flexible and functional than vanilla Skyrim. However, this added functionality comes with more dangers as well. All followers, with very few exceptions, are capable of being killed at any time. Only housecarls have the protected status, and even they can still go down to a stray fireball cast by the player. Hired mercenaries now require daily payment instead of just a one-time fee. Overall, followers in Wildlander are both stronger and weaker than they were in vanilla Skyrim. They are capable of more utility, but are also more vulnerable to permanent death. In vanilla Skyrim, talking and interacting with NPCs had very little impact on the game. Dialogue was a way to deliver quests and exposition about the world, and very little else. Now in Wildlander, your ability to persuade and cajole is much more meaningful, providing a genuine impact on your relationships with the characters in the province. Your followers have greater utility, able to perform more tasks than they used to, but are now more susceptible to the dangers of the world, requiring more careful attention to keep them alive. Overall, these systemic changes allow for a far more dynamic and reactive world. That's all for now. I hope this video will help you get started with followers and dialogue interactions in Wildlander. If you have any mods or mechanics that you'd like to see get an advanced guide, let me know in the comments. Thank you for watching, and goodbye.